Hi everyone, in this video I will explain how you can create interactive image to display specific data within your SAS Visual Analytics report. I will explain what is a data-driven content object. I will also cover what is an HTML image map and finally do a demo. So what is a data-driven content object? Data-driven content object is a SAS Visual Analytics component. The objective of this component is to use the integration of VA data within custom web pages that can be embedded within a SAS Visual Analytics report. It's often used to define visualizations that are not available out of the box within VA. The data-driven content object provides two-way interactions between VA report and the data-driven content object. It means that the interactions with any object in the VA report can filter data used by the data-driven content object, but it also means that you can interact with the data-driven content object to filter the data in other objects of the report. What is an HTML image map? An image map is a specific HTML tag which defines clickable areas on an image. The clickable areas can take the form of a circle, a rectangle, or a polygon. An image map is like a geographic map on which you define the regions you want to interact with. There is a limitation with the image map. If you want to resize the image, it can only be done using the zoom CSS style option. It's now time to have a small demo. In this demo, I will explain you how you can create a report with a data-driven content object. Let's first see the final result. I'm here in Visual Analytics. I've created a report. The report has three different objects at the top: control box, dropdowns that can filter the data. If, for example, I change from Europe to USA and then go for Ford, finally select the model, a Mustang, you see that the car is updated. The price tag is also updated. And if I click on a wheel, I get information about the wheelbase. If I click on the hook, I get information about the cylinders, engine size, and horsepower. And if I click on the tank hatch, I get information about the consumption. The question is now how this report was created. First, I will explain the HTML code and then I will show you the report definition. The HTML page and the image that are used to create the page are available on GitHub. I decided to use Bootstrap to define the layout of the page. Using Bootstrap, you can easily create a layout for your page with little to no CSS code. The page has two important parts: the container and the JavaScript. The container contains two sections. The first one is a row. That row will display the model and the price tag and the car specification, so basically the title. The second one will display the image map and the data about the area that was clicked. You might wonder how the map tag was created. There are some handy tools on the web to help you in that process. I use the image map website. So how can you use it? You select an image on your machine, the image that you want to use. It will load the image. Then you define the areas. So in this case, I will create a circle. You can click resize. You add a new area, a circle again. I add another one for the engine size, a circle. And then add a small one, a circle again for the consumption. Now that I've created all those links, all those areas, I will give them a title. The title is wheelbase. The second one is wheelbase. The third one is engine. And finally, consumption. Clicking on the show me the code will display the information about the image map. I can copy the code and then paste it in my HTML code. This is how I created the HTML code. As I mentioned earlier, you need to use a style to reduce the size of the image. If you are not doing it that way, resizing in another way, you will lose the mapped information. Now comes the time to wire all the components on the page and to provide data to them. This is the role of the JavaScript. I'm using jQuery to build the interaction between the different components. And I'm using some other JavaScript that are provided by SAS and that are available on GitHub. As you can see in the code, there are some interactions, emptying some divs, and collecting data from the VA. Those data are displayed as an array, so it's important when you design the report to exactly define the order of the variables in the data-driven content object. Otherwise, the data will not be displayed properly, but I will show you what can go wrong when I will go back with the edit of the report. So as a final step, I define which values should be displayed when wheelbase is clicked, when engine is clicked, or when the consumption is clicked. And that's it basically for the HTML that you have to develop. It's no time to go back to the report and see how it is designed. So I will go to the edit mode. In this case, you see that we have different objects, a drop-down list for the origin, a drop-down list for the make, and another one for the model. And we have finally the data-driven content object. So to define the data-driven content object options, we need to define the URL for the web page. In this case, the web page is hosted on my local machine where I have a web server running on port 3000. That's fine when you design your report and you want to test, because it needs to only have to be available to you. But as soon as you want to load this and make it available to others, you will have to host the file on a web server. You can therefore use the web server that is provided with the SAS via environment. Let's now see what roles are defined. So this is a SAS help car. So we have the model, the cylinders, engine size, and all the other variables that should be displayed. So if I click on the wheelbase, it's basically getting the last variable. So as you remember, we are using an array of data, and the data is, and the array is defined to use the last variable to display the wheelbase. So if I move the data around and I click on wheelbase, I see that I get the retail price when I click on the wheel, which is not what I want to see. So just move back the information, the variable to the correct place in order to get the correct information. That's it for the demo. Here are some interesting links to get more information about the topic I covered today. So working with data-driven content objects from the documentation. I have also another blog explaining how to use Day3GS in your report. And if the code that is used to populate the data from the VA report to the data-driven content object is available on GitHub on the link specified over here. Thank you for your attention, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips and tutorials.